The Sufia are a people who have gained proximity and closeness to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And due to that spiritual closeness to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala blesses them with spiritual abilities and powers and helps them, assists them with spiritual assistance. Unfortunately, you hear people denying these spiritual abilities and powers of Awliya and Sufiya. Let's refer back to Ibn Taymiyyah and see what he has to say in relation to this. In the 7th volume of Ibn Taymiyyah's Majmu'ul Fatawa, on page 134, Ibn Taymiyyah, he relates a story of one of the Tabi'un whose name was Silat ibn Ashyam. And he borrowed a horse, Silat ibn Ashyam, from somebody in order to go into battle. And when he went into battle, Ibn Taymiyyah writes, Mata farasuhu wa huwa fil ghazwi, that Silat ibn Ashyam's horse during the battle died. What does Silat ibn Ashyam do? In this desperate state, he raises his hands and he makes a dua, a supplication to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, that, O Allah, don't let it be the case that I cannot fulfill my duty to one of your creation and I cannot return the horse. He makes this dua. Ibn Taymiyyah writes, Wada Allah Azza wa Jalla. He supplicated to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, Fa ahya lahu farasahu. In reply to his dua, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, lahu, for him, for Silat ibn Ashyam, ahya lahu farasahu, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala brought this dead horse back to life due to the supplication of one of his awliya. What do we learn from this? That Ibn Taymiyyah, he believed that the supplications of the awliya can even bring the dead back to life.